Hi, I'm Chris Rowe, and welcome to the Understanding and Using Cow Calls video series. If you're like me, and thousands of other elk hunters out there, at some point in your preparations for elk season each fall, your attention ends up turning to elk calls, whether it be to simply practice up a little bit and brush up on the ones that you already have, or to get some new replacements, or just add some new calls to your arsenal. But with so many different types of cow calls on the market these days, it can be a bit confusing, if not downright overwhelming, trying to figure out how the different calls are used, how to get the best sound out of them, how each one might sound in comparison to one another, and which one you should buy if you happen to be in the market for one. Over the next several videos, we're going to go a long way into helping you figure all that out. Now, before we begin, let me be clear that this series is not a sales pitch for any particular company per se. Neither this nor the companion videos in Understanding and Using Bugles and Bugle Tubes are sanctioned by or endorsed by any company in particular, and they are not meant to bash any company or their products. Rather, these videos are intended to show you how to use the different types of calls, help you understand the mechanics of and the realities around the different types of calls, and help you make a more educated purchase when you're shopping for a cow call, and then get the most out of the call or calls that you do purchase. With that said, there are a number of manufacturers of elk calls out there, with each one having their own styles, designs, and materials they use to make their calls and the associated marketing campaigns to go along with them. Because of the different designs and materials, some calls do sound better than others, both between manufacturers and even within a particular manufacturer's line. In this series, I'll go over an assortment of different types of calls from several different manufacturers and not only show you how to use them and get the best sound out of them, but I'll also give you the advantages and disadvantages of each from my perspective so you can decide which call might be right for you. As we go through the videos, we'll go from the most basic and easiest calls to use to those that I consider to be the most versatile, but that might take a little bit more practice to master. And we'll break them down into what I consider the different classes of calls that are available. Now, there is no way to cover all the cow elk calls that are out there on the market, but I'll go over the different classes within the four companies that are probably the most popular, or at least those that you're likely to see on TV, or hear folks talking about at your local sporting goods shop or on online chat forums. Those being Primos Hunting Calls, Bugling Bull Game Calls, Hunter Specialties or Carlton Calls, and more recently, Mossback Game Calls. As far as the different classes of cow calls that we'll be talking about in this series, we're going to be covering mechanical calls, those calls that are operated solely by hand, manual calls, those that you blow through but you manipulate the sound by hand, bite and blow style calls, mouth diaphragm calls, and open reed style calls. Now, before diving into the calls themselves, let me explain a concept that I'll be referring to throughout the videos when evaluating each of the calls. Like we talk about in Understanding Cow Elk Vocalizations and Communication, different elk have different voices or vocal signatures, just like we do. My voice is different from yours, yours is different from your friends, etc. Elk calls are no different. Different calls will have different vocal signatures based on their design, the materials they're made of, and how they're used. When you look across the spectrum of all the different sounds elk make and evaluate those sounds based on the different vocal signatures of the animals, if you were to plot how the different vocal signatures fell out on a graph, it would look something like a standard bell curve. A lot of elk having very similar vocal signatures and sounding similar to one another, with a few elk having very distinct or unique vocal signatures. Maybe they sound squeaky and bird-like, or maybe they're deep, hoarse, and raspy. When calling elk, there can be advantages to imitating the sounds and general vocal signatures of the majority of elk that you're likely to encounter, essentially using calls and sounding like the elk that fall into that fat part of the bell curve. However, there can be times when standing out from the crowd can be good, so being able to have a unique vocal signature, like one of the elk that might be out at the ends of the bell curve, can be an advantage. As we discuss the different calls in this series, I'll talk about how well the calls work the curve or fits in the bell curve so you can get an idea of what the call will do from a vocal signature standpoint. Some calls have very distinct, very unique vocal signatures, while others can work more of that curve. Being able to cover the center of the bell or work a broad spectrum within the curve can help you blend into the herd or the bulk of the elk that you're likely going to be dealing with, and can be great for general calling and for versatility and forgiveness when working a certain individual animal or a consistent group of animals over multiple occasions. They might be less likely to identify you and pattern you specifically. Essentially, you blend in and you don't stand out. However, a call that maybe fits out towards the end of the curve may be unique enough to stand out from the crowd if that's what you want or need in a particular situation. A call that can do both, well, that's even better. So when you hear me talk about a call working the curve or fitting the curve in a particular way or place, that's what I'm talking about. How does the call fit within the spectrum of cow elk sounds?